What does the story about cute little piglets have to do with supplements and longevity? Well, the things I love to do, I watch YouTube, read the latest anti-aging research, and look for good metaphors to bring that research to life here. And we've already discussed supplement myths during my trip to Harvard Medical School.
Supplements?
You got it.
There was this quote from sitcom Big Bang Theory, mm-hmm. where Sheldon runs around supermarket vitamin section and tells people, you're buying ingredients for a very expensive urine.
Also, if you follow Peter Attia, you might find the same ideas in his book Outlive, The Art and Science of Longevity.
And I guess we're talking about this through the lens of supplements. Well, I think we have to acknowledge that there's a great uncertainty with many of these things.
But yesterday, I ran into another what's your anti-aging supplement stack question on Reddit, and that got me thinking. How to bring these points across in a way which would make them finally stick? Because our money and our lives are on the line here, and we don't want to waste them, do we? And so, once upon a time, there was a big bad wolf, and his name started with AG and ended with ING. And in this story, you and I, a cute little pink oinks oinks, he's after. So, what kind of house are we going to build to protect us? Do we have a plan? Foundation? Safety inspection? I have personally started from a straw house. Resveratrol, Enemann, Taurine, that kind of stuff. It was almost exactly 4 years ago, Friday morning, right after Thanksgiving, when I woke up after big family dinner, looked into the mirror,
like that.
And decided that it's time to look for anti-aging pills. And almost instantly, just like that, the partner of that wolf showed up, a sly fox, supplement industry. And here are some numbers for you. That industry is about 160 billion in size, big B. It's like Pfizer and Johnson together, but unbound by FDA rules.
I mean, the problem is the whole supplement world's kind of a shit show. So unregulated.
Which means unknown quantities of the active ingredients, unverified claims, and ruthless advertisement. You think Big Pharma is bad? Well, at least they're obligated to improve our lives in some ways. But the fox, he's just after the money. And because I was born in the Soviet Union, I would usually be okay with that, let the economy grow. But not this time. Not just because of the direct cost, the wasted money, but also because the cost of opportunities, money not directed to the meaningful solutions, which would stop the wolf from getting to us with a single blow. So that straw house which I was building looks cool, it gives some shade, and makes you feel like you're doing something. But when I actually started to dig in, talk with and listen to the specialists, I realize that if you do not at least measure the results of whatever supplements you take...
Oh boy!
What now?
Well, there is some value to taking in them in, but the human body can only absorb so much. You are buying here ingredients for the very expensive urine.
Well, maybe that's what I was going for.
Well, then you want some resveratrol.
The main fundamental difference between the straw house and the house of sticks, the next level of fortification, is to remember that the word supplement literally means to supplement, to cover the deficiencies which you cannot get otherwise through the diet or lifestyle. And for that, for my new house, I had to refocus, and now I only take what I know I can measure in a meaningful way. Let me give you a few examples. I have MTHFR mutation, and so I tend to undermethylate. And if it's left unchecked, my homocysteine runs high, and so I take combination of NAC and methylated vitamin B to keep my homocysteine levels below 9. I have parathyroid issues, thanks to Chernobyl, and so I take vitamin D and K2 combo to keep my PTH hormone and calcium levels in check. I have dementia history in my family, and so I take extra fish oil to keep my membrane omega levels at 12%. So today, almost nothing on my list is random, and everything is taken with some biofeedback. And that's how you build the house of sticks. It has some foundation, it's a little more solid, But when it comes to longevity and aging, it's still a far cry or oink from the real protection. It's about healthy aging, but not about life extension. For that, we need a real house, the house of stones. But here's a problem, the real problem. As of this year, there's not a single clinically tested anti-aging drug on the market. Zilch, nada, nicht. The nearest one to be tested is metformin as a part of TAME trial, which is very appropriately called targeting aging with metformin. And that's where opportunity cost I was talking about before is really biting us back. It has been almost 10 years, 10, since TAME trial has been proposed, and it's still up to this day trying to collect the funds to get started. If just a small fraction of money wasted on useless supplements went toward TAME trial, we could have the first real stone to build, to start building solid wall against that wolf. And then we could probably test rapamycin clinically test some senolytics, and there are actually 1 million of molecules identified to be tested. So what's the bottom line? If you're taking supplements, only take what has a solid clinically proven record and can be measured and readjusted to your personal needs. Use the link below to help TAME trial to get started, or pick any other way to support the anti-aging research or help to advocate it. That's how you get significantly better return on your investments. That's what I do, and you're welcome to join. And check the rest of my conversation in Harvard Medical School for much better ways to improve your health than some pills, so you can live long enough to see the results of these investments. Aging is bad, living is smart, and I'll see you there shortly.